Where are we on the school lunch article?
We thought we would make it about how the prices of ice cream have gone up 15 cents in the cafeteria, and...
That's a bit vanilla, pardon the pun, but you're missing the meat of the story. Our school serves pizza 5 days a week, paid by taxpayer money that is used to cover us against pizza-induced diabetes. Now that's a school lunch story. Boom, copy that, circle it, write it. Huh? Nailed it. I'm so proud of me. We came up with that idea together, but mostly me. Okay, next up, final assignment, all right? It's a doozy, but it's a real feather in the cap for any reporter worth their salt that wants to comment on the social life of the school. Anyone? Not all at once. No one. No one at all. Any takers? Bianca. Just the gal I was hoping for.
Hello.
Okay. I want you to step out of your comfort zone and bring your special brand of journalistic gravitas to an article about homecoming. Specifically, what homecoming means to me. I mean, not to me. I never went to a dance when I was a kid. Kind of a nerd.
Sorry to interrupt, Mr. Arthur, but with all due respect, I'm...
You're honored and thrilled to lend that Bianca Piper magic.
You want to do your thing and put some stuff in the words and make a pop?
That's so nice of you. You don't have to do that. Oh, no, you didn't. I didn't say that. Yes, you did. And thank... No, I didn't. Yes, you did. And I thank you. Oh, no, I did not. You did. And I thank you.
Yeah, that's not where I was going with that.
Not likely.
Don't we just look so cute together?
Ooh. Problem solved.
Solved my ass. This school, this entire school is filled with cyberbullies. Do you know what that means? That means retaliation videos, comments, likes, tweets, memes, and whatever the hell else they do to each other nowadays. It's like a prison yard out there.
Don't you think you're overreacting just a little bit?
Have you not seen Dateline? Catfish? Pretty Little Liars?
What?
Nothing.
Look, having had experience in this area, I think we gotta deal with this in a way that's private and sensitive.
Yes, yes. We do not negotiate with terrorists.
That is the opposite of what I just said.
This video was hysterical. Eat a dick.
Thanks. Just had a bagel though, so I'm full.
Mr. Arthur, I'm really sorry.
Nah, don't worry about it. Step into my hallway. I don't play favors, but you're my favorite. You ever heard the phrase, the pen is mightier than the sword?
Yeah, and in this case, a bunch of kids anonymously typing whatever comments they want feels like an atomic bomb, and that's definitely mightier than a sword.
So, make your writing have a positive effect, as in a certain homecoming article does do?
Please, Mr. Arthur, the last thing I want to do is go to a place where everybody hates me and then write about it.
I picked you for a reason. And whatever you write, I'm running it as our lead, so make it count.
Inspire us. Remember, the pen is mightier than the sword.
Simon, get your finger out of there.
You're not my father.
Wow. For what it's worth, what you wrote here struck a chord with me as well. I mean, I know you won't believe me, but I was a duff out of my friends.
What? No.
There was no cool name for it, like the duff. It was like the dipshit, douchebag, A. Urkel, Asian Urkel.
Nerdass.
Okay, you know, didn't need the help, you know?
Oh. Whoa, look at this. The site has thousands of comments and likes on it. Look, they're positive this time.
Mr. Arthur was right. Kids started writing to me with their own duff stories, and when I posted those, more kids responded until it just became its own thing.